Alright, what's up y'all? It's Lee Fair here. In today's video, man, like I said in the title, this is how to get hot zones, aka how to shoot better with your inside big men. Now, there's a lot of stuff and info that I need to get to you guys on. Real quick, I'm gonna break down what's going to benefit you a lot while doing this. Now, don't worry about putting yourself at the three. As well as, by the way, either you need to get very lucky with how you pick your team, or you haven't made this big man yet, or you need to be a 90 overall. So let me explain all the things that make this so much easier. Now, you can still do this the same way as everybody else, but for things to benefit you, I want to give you guys some advice. Now, for instance, I have Lonzo Ball on my team who has Gold Dimer. I have Chris Paul who has Gold Dimer. For a while there, I'm actually in my second year now, but what you can do as well when you hit 90 overall is, you know, come to this team thing, influence trade, and I know he's on the Pelicans now, but I tried to get Rondo as well, who I believe also has Gold Dimer. Here, I'll go there and show you guys real quick. Unless he already got, he really got traded from them too. Okay, I don't know where Rondo is now, but anyway, yeah, Rondo has Gold Dimer as well, and they all have on-court coach as well, which, which makes your teammates play better on offense. Anyway, point being of this is that having Dimer and on-court coach and stuff, it'll make your dude shoot better. For instance, I lead the league. Here, I'm going to show you guys this as well. I have 2 3-point hot zones. I have everything mid-range and in. And you see my dude's worst percentage on the floor is like 37% from the right corner, which I'm not sure how I even have that hot zone, to be honest. I think you need to make at least like 30 shots from an area. I'm not sure. For whatever reason though, at the top of the key, I had 38, and then literally one more three-pointer puts me to the hot zone. Anyway, like I said, there's a lot of stuff in this video I'm gonna have to explain, so just stay tuned. It's a lot of information. So let's get to the next set of information, basically. What you're going to do is you want to be at the beginning of your season. So all you have to do, play the first game of the year. I'm going to go to this box score and show you that. I literally just... now here's what I'm going to go to some game clips. So you see, I had 160 points on 78 of 84 shooting. This is what I want y'all to do, all right? Now I'm gonna come to my game clips real quick and we'll pick it up from there. Basically, man, this is what I want y'all to do. Just cherry pick on the other end of the court and literally just stand in the paint and wait for the ball and just put up a layup or dunk as soon as you get it. You're gonna get open looks every single time. Now check this out too. Even if they decide to, or you know, if they make the shot and now you can't like just cherry pick, obviously, you know, they're going back to the court. Still sit in the paint and call for the ball. Just try to get as many easy looks as you possibly can. Now I'm gonna show you guys some screenshots, like I said. So, you know, this is just at the end of the year. I was picking my team. I was going back to the Lakers. This is also a tip of making more VC as well. See, I'm asking for more money on each team. You know, I was at 530 with the Lakers the first time. Now I went up to 565. Asked for more money again, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, point of this is just like, you know, you can get more VC off that. Like I said though, 160 points on 78. Or on 76 of 84 shooting. And this is the sim. These are the sim numbers. I led the league in 3-point percentage. I actually didn't like show the. There we go. There's the screenshot where I sorted my 3-point percentage. I actually led the league in 3-point percentage with an athletic rebounder. So anyway, I just wanted to show you guys me just simming out of the game now. I just, you know, sim to the end, ask for no VC, blah, blah, blah. Now, I guess basically what I'm trying to break down here is that once you get, you know, on your new team or whatever, or at the beginning of the season, you're just going to play that one game, get, like, as many points as you possibly can in the paint to get your guy, like, going hot and, like, you know, get his, there's, like, this icon in the My Minutes thing I'll show you in a sec. You know, it just details the stuff that you have. So I went into this game with only, like, 3 hot zones. It was the inside, it was the very middle one, and then the 3 around it. So I had like 4 hot zones. Then you're gonna see right after this is that I loaded up my MyPlayer Lab league stats. Now real quick, I want to show you guys this icon I'm talking about, this little red hot circle thing that you see on me, Chris Bosch, and then Chris Paul has two of them. I think the orange one is for passing and the red one's for shooting. I'm not sure. But anyway, so you see now I have all the mid-range ones, and I personally grinded for that right corner and that top of the key like you saw, which only took me like two more threes on that stuff anyway. So anyway, so now you see like literally the game clip like barely after it. Now I have the right corner and the top of the key. Like I said, having Chris Paul and Lonzo Ball and even like, okay, so if you're going to a brand new team and you don't have like, so basically let's say, as I'm gonna come back out to 2K now, let's say you don't have a team yet, like you are just creating your guy and you want to know how to get hot zones, which is very unlikely. I know not many people are probably gonna, you know, be looking up this video before they even made their guy. Also, you can just try to get traded to the Rockets. So like I said, you guys saw Chris Paul's badges. Now I'm gonna show you James Harden's badges as well. Yeah, there we go. I was gonna say, I'm just assuming that he's at the top of the league in scoring per game. Now I'm gonna show you James Harden's badges. Like I said, he has Gold Dimer as well. If you go to the Rockets, they have two guys with Gold Dimer. Then just look for Rondo. If you are 90 overall, look for Rondo, and you'll be able to have three guys with Gold Dimer. And you can just put yourself wherever you want in the lineup. But assuming not many people who are watching this are a 90 overall, like I said, just request a trade to the Rockets. You're gonna have two guys at Dimer. Hopefully your minutes are pretty decent. If not, like I said, bro, 90 overall is the key to all of this. This is just a way of upping your game and just becoming better. And I feel like it's a pretty useful way. It's a pretty useful thing in every year of 2K to get hot zones. You see, I have 63 mid-range, 58 three-pointer. I'm hoping that this will truly help me like shoot better, which, as far as I've noticed, it definitely has. Anyway, man, like I said, and even being 91 overall might help this as well, because you would get on-court coach, which is, you know, pretty beneficial to, you know, calling for the ball when you need it. Anyway, that's about it for the video. Like I said, just to go over everything one more time briefly. Literally, all you're gonna do, start at the very beginning of the year, go ham, just get as many points as you can in order for you to get this little red ring right here. And then after you're done with that game, just sim all the way over here. Simple as that. And like I said, okay, when I say all the way over here, I mean like literally right here. But yeah, anyway. And then once you get into this, just go into this game. And then literally sim out as soon as you get into it. You don't need to wait until you can ask out with VC. You don't have to do any of that. Just go into the game, sim out. That's when you'll see these hot zones actually start to come in here. So let's say you start the beginning of the year, right? And then you have blank hot zones. Now you sim to this point. You sim to this point right here. Don't assume that you're just gonna have your hot zones after this Utah game, aka the 82nd game of the season. Let me try to break this down for you, because I know it's pretty complicated. You will see all of this look like this. Like, you'll see a ton of red, all this stuff. But you're not gonna have any of these hot zones. You get those hot zones once you go into this game and sim out of it. So simple as that. Anyway, I know I probably over-explained in this video. I just wanted to make sure I could clarify it for anybody who has any of the questions to me, you know, with any of this stuff on how to get the hot zones. Honestly, man, you guys are probably going to be like, bro, you have an athletic rebounder. Why are you trying to even do this stuff? You guys know me. I'm over here working on the dribble game. I'm working on the shooting. I made this dude so he could rebound and dunk. There's four categories. I mean, what else is there for categories? I mean, defense. I like to think I'm already pretty good at that. This dude can do everything. Like, and okay, I am pretty good at post game as well. So that's probably my weakest aspect, just because of the build. But yeah, man, dribbling, I feel like a legit point forward out there, minus the momentum crosses. 3-point shooting, I am hoping that this actually improves quite a bit. I'm not even too bad at it, to be honest, though, for having 58. I would say I'm about like 50-50 already. Mid-range, this is pretty wet already. And then obviously the layups and dunks are just OP. So anyway, hey, like I said, just working on the game, trying to get better at everything else. I know I'm a little bit behind in my little qualifying wins. I'm only at 22, and it's literally like, let me see what the date is. It's literally It's literally January 16th as I'm recording this. That's pretty rough. I'm pretty behind schedule. I'm trying to get some walk-on dubs pretty soon. I've really just been doing straight team pro-am for the majority of this whole process. But my team is we're just not playing enough to get to my pace of 50. So I'm probably going to end up playing some walk-on, get some easy dubs on this. I just need probably a point guard, nothing more than that, really. If you guys are a pure playmaker or like a play sharp or something with Dimer, feel free to let me know. I would really appreciate, you know, having someone who's willing to just pass me the ball, like, every play. I mean, I don't really have to, though. I mean, it's just getting dubs, but I feel like I could really, like, you know, get some badge progress as well while doing it. Anyway, it's all for the vid. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Like I said, I know I've been kind of lacking with the videos lately. I think I had like 6 days or something like where I didn't upload. And I apologize for that. I've just been kind of busy with stuff, work. I was really excited for this football game too with the Vikings. And man, my mood has been uplifted so much because of that game. Like, I went from that was the biggest emotional swing of my life. I was depressed for the whole fourth quarter, and then all of a sudden, with 10 seconds left, my whole mood just takes a 180. Like, it was the most uplifting thing ever. Anyway, it's all for the vid. I hope you guys enjoyed. Like I said, if you have any questions, feel free to let me know. I'm here to help for anybody who doesn't understand anything I portrayed in the video. But anyway, other than that, hope you guys enjoyed. Take it easy, man. Peace.